Hi there you guys, I'm Teddy from BijuTeo Beading with another Christmas gift idea project. By the way, these cute 3D ribbons you could use not only for Christmas project but for other holidays, and you could decorate the gifts you prepare with those ribbons. I have a tutorial for flat ribbon earrings and flat ribbon ring, and I'll link them also here at the eye icon, and I will link my whole Christmas playlist, which is really long one because my channel is 4 years old now and I have 4 Christmas that I've been preparing for. And here I'm using just simple seed beads and simple brick stitch. If you are familiar with them, you will have no problem. And even if you are a beginner, I'm showing step by step, and I'm sure you're gonna be able to make them by yourself. Tell me in the comments which ones you like more, the flat ribbons or the 3D ribbons, and are you going to try to make them? Okay, so now guys, I'm going to start with a list of the materials. Okay guys, so what I'm using here for this video are 2 colors of 11-0 seed beads, golden and red. Here I use these ear wires in old gold color. This is monofilament, that is 0.006 inches or 0.15 millimeters. You could use other beading thread of your choice. This is size 10 beading needle, scissors, and these are flat nose pliers. Now I'm going to take about an arm span of thread on my needle. It should be enough for my ribbon earring, and I'll be back. Okay guys, and I'm back, and what I want to do next is take 2 seed beads because I want to start the central part of my ribbon. Okay, and I'm sliding those down. Okay, just like this. I will stick my needle in my mat, and here what I want to do is make a knot. Okay, I'm making my knot. Okay, let's do a double knot. Okay, now I have this. And in my next step, guys, what I want to do is go back through these 2 beads, just like this. Okay, now this is what I have. And I'm going to take 2 more beads, okay? And I'm going back in circle through these 2 beads. Okay, and I have this. Then I'm going through those 2 newly added beads. 2 more. And go back. Okay, and back again. And I want to tighten this up a little bit. Okay, like this. And I'm going to repeat this, guys, 3 more times. Okay, now I have the middle part almost ready, but I want to flip it like this, 3 rows like this and 3 like this. And now guys, I want to connect my last row with my first row. Okay, so as I'm exiting here from these last 2 beads, what I do is that I go through the very first 2 beads that I have. Okay, and I pull. Then what I do is that I go back again through these 2 beads. And 1 more time, guys, through the very first 2 beads that I added here. Okay. So now guys, I have this. Now what I wanna do next, after I have this 3D central part of my ribbon, is to take 2 golden seed beads, and I'm going to start making the familiar brick stitch. As I take those two beads, I go under the first thread bridge of my beads that are next to each other, with the holes pointing out, as you may see. I go through them, and I go through the one that is closer to the center of my work. Okay, this is how I start brick stitch, okay? Then I take one more seed bead. I go through the following brick stitch. Okay, and I go here through this one. And what I want to do, guys, is add one more. Just one seed bead and go through the last thread bridge that I've been through in my previous step. Okay, like that. And then back through this seed bead that I just added. So if you're not familiar with the brick stitch, this is it. And this is expanding brick stitch, where I have three red beads and after them I attach four golden beads. And in my next step, guys, I'm going to add five beads. That is why it's an expanding brick stitch, and I prefer to flip my work like this, in this direction. And in my next step, I'm taking two seed beads, going through the very first thread bridge here. When I expand, I always go through the first thread bridge, then through the bead that is closer to the center of my work and to my needle, and I pull. Then at each thread bridge I add one seed bead. Okay, this is the second thread bridge and I add one seed bead. Okay, like this. This is the third thread bridge and I add one seed bead. And at the third, which is the last thread bridge, I add one more. Okay, then I go through the last thread bridge here at the end that I have already been through with my last seed bead. I go through it again and I go back through the last one. So when I expand, I always start with two seed beads. I always go first through the first thread bridge and then at the last thread bridge I add two beads one by one. Okay, so this is it, and I'll show you one more row. Okay, I'm taking two seed beads, going through the very first thread bridge here, pulling, then going through the one that's closer to the center of my work, pull again. Then I will add seed beads in this direction. Okay, and in this row, guys, I have six beads, okay? In my next row, I will have seven, then eight, then nine, then 10. And I'm sure if you've done these rows, you will be able to make the next four rows. So you will have seven rows from here, and the last row will consist of 10 beads, okay? And don't worry with this band here that is forming. This is a wanted effect. I know if you're using delicate beads, you won't have this band. Everything will be nice and tight and in a shape without a band. But now this is a wanted effect. Okay, continue and meet me. Okay, guys, and I just finished the seventh row from here, and it consists of 10 beads. Okay, when I was making the flat ribbon, this was enough and I could finish it just with an edge here, and that was it. Okay, but now I'm going to show you the 3D ribbon effect, and I will make it by now starting to decrease and bending, okay? So now I take two seed beads, but because it's time to start decreasing, I will take them and go under the second thread bridge this time. So I'm skipping the first one and I'm going through the second thread bridge and I'm going back through this seed bead here that is closer to the center. But what I want to do also is go back through those two beads one more time, because when I'm decreasing the beads from the first row just look some kind of wonky, and I need to go one more time through them, okay? So now I continue as usual, adding one by one beads. And this time, since I'm decreasing in this row, I should have 9 seed beads. Okay guys, and that's it. I'm adding 9 beads here and I stop and I start decreasing in this way. And don't worry that it looks some kind of odd and strange, because when we bend it, it will just look great. Okay, every defect in effect. So now the next row will consist of 8 beads. Okay, so I take 2. And I go not through the first thread bridge, but through the second thread bridge. And since I'm going through the second, my beads stay strange, so I should go reinforcing them. This is when I decrease. Brick stitch, when decreasing, you should go reinforce the first two beads of your row, and you start from the second thread bridge. And at your last step, at your last thread bridge, you add only 1 seed bead instead of 2. So this is the difference between decreasing and increasing brick stitch, if you don't know it. Okay, now I have 8 beads, and again, don't worry, it looks strange. Okay, now guys, I'm sure you could continue this with 7, 6, 5, 4 beads, and when you have a row with 4 beads, you stop and I'll be back to tell you what's coming up next. Okay guys, and when I continue beading and I'm up to this row, which consists of 4 beads, this is what I have. If you work with delicate beads, this shape, as I showed you many times before, and I will link here tutorials that I'm showing what beautiful straight shape is forming from delicate beads following those steps. Maybe you wonder what I'm going to do now. Okay, what I'm going to do is flip it like this, and I will still have a perfect and cool shape, okay? When I flip it like this, you see this row here, these 4 beads are attached to this row, and these 4 beads will be attached to the opposite row that I created in the beginning. Okay, so as I'm exiting here from this seed bead, I'm going here through this red bead, okay, like this. Then I will go through this central red bead and back through this one here, through the second one. Then what I do is that I go through the third one and again through this central one. Okay. And then I'm going through the last one here and through the golden. Then what I wanna do, guys, is reposition my thread and go back through this red bead here, because I wanna start. You see how beautiful it looks, this shape, a 3D ribbon, and I wanna start the same shape from here. Okay, and in order to do this, I will flip. Okay, this knot will hide when I make my next row and close it. Okay, and I take two seed beads. I go under the first thread bridge the same way I showed you before. Now I'm making an expanding brick stitch. Okay, and I go through the seed bead that's closer to the center of my work. Then I take one seed bead again. I go back through the next thread bridge and I go here. Okay, and here I need one more seed bead. I go one more time under the last thread bridge in this row and I go back through this one here. Okay, now I started with four beads. I'll flip it. And from now on, guys, it is the same like I showed you from here. You expand until you have 10 beads in a row, so it's 7 beads from here, and then you start decreasing. And if you forgot those steps, just rewind this video and see how I'm making this part and repeat it. Okay, I will continue until I have this part finished and I'll be back to tell you how to finish your. Okay guys, and as I continued beading the same way, you see I have the same thing like this one from here, and now I'm going to show you one more time how to fold it and connect it to the other side of your work. Okay, now I'm exiting out of this seed bead here at the edge and I'm going through the first red bead. This is what I showed you already, but I'm showing it one more time. Then I'm going back through this red one and through this golden one, the next golden, okay, the second golden. Now I'm exiting out of the second golden. If you don't see my thread, here it is. Then I go through the third golden and back through the red one. Okay, and I pull. And then what I do is that I go through the red one here, like this. Okay, and again here through the last golden to connect them. Okay, so now this is what I have, and I want to go back here, let's say through this golden and back through the red beads. Okay, so I'm exiting through one of my red beads, and now it's time to attach my ear wire. And how I do this, I'm taking it and I take six red beads, let's say three seed beads, my ear wire, and three more seed beads. Okay, and then as I'm exiting through one of those red beads, I'm going back in circle through both of them. Okay, just like this. Okay, now I have this beautiful circle and I'm going to reinforce it. Okay, and this will be the front of my earring. And now guys, what I want to do next is go here through some beads in this direction and make a knot. Let's say I'm going here through four beads. I make here a loop. And then I go once and I go second time through this loop I've made. Then I make sure I'm between those two beads where I started my knot from. Pull again. Now I will go through the following seed bead and I'm going to cut my thread. Okay. And now my 3D Christmas ribbon earring is ready. Okay guys, so now my 3D Christmas ribbon earrings are ready. So if you like them and you want to see more and more videos like this, it's a good idea to subscribe and also hit the bell button. And in this way you will be inspired at least 2 times a week and you will see all my Christmas tutorials to be ready for the holidays and prepare your gifts. And you could also like, share and comment, and you don't know how much of a support this is. If you make beautiful jewelry following my tutorials, please share them on my social pages that I shared down there. And also in description you will find the full list of materials, link to my store, link for PayPal donations to develop this channel, and link to my second channel where I make fast clips of some of my videos, and you could see the whole project in just 2-3 minutes. Decide if you feel like making it or not, or just enjoy the process of creation. So thank you so much for watching. That was all from me.